Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as unearned revenue. That's sales. As you can see, there's an extract that has been taken. It's on the liability in the stockholders' equity side. In the current liability, the deferred revenue has been shown here, the unearned revenue, right? This was just to show exactly where your unearned revenue or the deferred revenue has been located. Let's begin. The unearned revenue is the category of the accrual under which the company receives the cash before it actually provides goods or renders services. So under the cash exchange happens before the actual goods or services delivered, and as such no revenue is recorded by the company. The company, however, is under no obligation to provide the goods or any or render any service as the case may be. So on due dates which the advance payments have been received by it, and as such the unearned revenue is a liability till the time it does not completely fulfills the same, and the amount gets reduced proportionately as the service is being provided by the business. So it is also known as by the name of unearned revenue. Or we also call it as a deferred revenue, deferred income as well. Okay. The most basic example of unearned revenue is that of the magazine subscription. Now, when we register for an annual subscription of our favorite magazine, the revenue received by the company is unearned. So as they deliver magazine each month, the company keeps on recognizing the corresponding income in the income statement. Okay, so as they deliver the magazine, they do a corresponding effect in the income statement. Now we'll understand the unearned revenue is basically a liability on their balance sheet. See, normally the unearned revenue on balance sheet is reported under current liability. However, if the unearned is not expected to be realized as actual revenue, then it can be reported as the long-term liability. As an example, you know, unearned revenue for many companies of sales, they have some details regarding. Let me show you that extract. Now, this is the extract that we were supposed to see, right? There's a deferred revenue, which is also known as the unearned revenue on the current liability side. Well, in case it is available on a current liability side and it is shown under that particular head. Now, we need to understand the accounting part of the unearned revenue. When a company basically receives cash for goods or services that it will provide in future, it leads to increase in cash balance, okay, of the company. Now, since the goods or services to be provided in future, the unearned income is basically shown as the liability in the unearned revenue balance sheet of the company, which resulted in proportional increase on both sides of the unearned revenue account, which is shown in the balance sheet. Let me get you this whole thing into some example. Let's say there's a company called XYZ, which pays $12,000 for some maintenance and cleaning contract to, let's say, KG Inc. for a period of 12 months. Now, how will KG Inc. will record this unearned sales revenue on the balance sheet? So it will be something like this. The cash amount which they are going to receive, that's $12,000. To deferred revenue, that will be $12,000, right? So the unearned revenue on the balance sheet will look like something like this. Like, you know, the asset on the asset side, the cash increase by $12,000. Okay, on the liability side, there will be deferred revenue increase by $12,000. That is your current liability. So your asset will be equal to your liability plus shareholders' equity. We all know that. And on the shareholders' equity side, there'll be nothing. Okay, so this is how the effect will go about. After working for a month, let's say MNC or KG Inc. has earned, let's say, $1,000, and it has provided its service to, let's say, XYZ company. So KG Inc. has provided service to XYZ company, and it will accrue its earnings. So the entry will go something like this. Deferred revenue account will be debited to $1,000. Service revenue, which will be $1,000. Hence, $1,000 of the earned income will be recognized as the service revenue, and the service revenue will in turn affect the profit and loss account in the shareholders' equity section. So in this scenario, what will happen? Your asset side will be nil. On the liability side, the deferred revenue, which instead of increasing, it will decrease in this particular case on the current liability side. And here in the shareholders' equity side, the service revenue will increase by 1,000. It affects the retained earning. That's why. So this is how it's going to be in the second scenario. Okay. So it is important to understand that, you know, while analyzing a company, earned sales revenue should be taken into consideration as it is an indication of the growth visibility of the business. Now, higher the earned income highlights the stronger order inflow of the company and also results in good liquidity of the business as a whole. I'll write for you good liquidity so that this is visible. So, and furthermore, the earned income does not result in any cash outflow in future as it only earned sales revenue, a liability on the earned sales revenue part of the balance sheet, which is reduced as a revenue, and it is recognized when providing the goods and service proportionately. Right. There are two types of earned sales revenue reporting. The first is the liability method. Under this method, when the deferred revenue is received by the business, a liability account is created. Okay, the basic premise behind using the liability method for reporting earned sales revenue is that the amount is yet to be earned, and till that time, you can say that the business should report the earned sales revenue as a liability. The common liability account is used in the deferred revenue, and the earned revenue balance sheet, it has actually been disclosed. The second is the income method. Under this method, when the earned sales revenue is received by the business, the whole amount that has been received is recorded under the income account, and proportionately adjusted to the goods or service which has been delivered by the business over the period of time as goods or service been provided. Now, let's understand the two types of earned sales revenue reporting through example. Let's say there is a company called ABC Business, and the company receives an annual subscription of 12,000 from one of its clients on 31/3/2018 for next year. So the revenue will be earned when the magazine will be delivered to the client on monthly basis. But the earned revenue balance on 31/3/2018 will show increase in the cash balance. So the cash balance has to increase by that amount of the annual subscription of 12,000, right? And the earned income, a liability will be created. The said liability will decrease the proportional amount of 1,000 on 30/4/2018 when the ABC delivers the first installment of the business magazine to the client, and accordingly ABC Limited will deliver the remaining business magazine to its client month on month, and the same will result in the revenue recognition. So at the end of the year on 31/3/2019, the deferred revenue, a liability, will cease to exist and all the revenue will be recognized in the income statement of ABC Limited. So this is how the two methods that were supposed to be explained in terms of earned revenue. That's it for earned revenue. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.